كتاب الله دستوري، كتاب الله دستوري، وخير الخلق أسوتنا،
بسنته انجلى نوري، لهدي الحق أرشدنا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. My dear and beloved mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers and honorable youth and children and dear viewers of ITV, I greet you once again with the universal greetings of love and peace and mercy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear ones, listen to the good news and the glad tidings. And this is what the Quran is all about, giving us glad tidings. Inna alladhina qalu rabbuna Allah thumma istaqamu. Those people who said proudly, Allah is our Lord, Allah is our Creator. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And then they take the right path. They are firm and steadfast on the right path. Listen to what Allah says. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. There is no grief for them and no fear. أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. They will be the companions of the Jannah, says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will be forever in the Jannah. In another ayah, in a different place in the Quran, Allah says, also, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. Those people who proudly say that Allah is our Creator, and then they affirm on the obedience of Allah. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. Allah says, at the time of death, Allah will send malaika to them to tell them, don't fear and don't grieve. We are your awliya, we are your protectors. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا وَأَبَشِّرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. Imagine, my dear ones, if we live on the straight path at the time of death, at the time when people are so worried and so fearful, the malaika sent by Allah will tell you, وَأَبَشِّرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. Good news, you will make it to the Jannah. And don't worry about your family and your children because of your goodness and your righteousness. Allah will look after them. Allahu Akbar. Immediately after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again reminds us about our responsibilities and duties towards our parents and to be dutiful to them. In other words, respectful, devoted, and submissive to our parents. And then immediately Allah says, after Allah enjoins us to be good to our parents, Allah says, and your mother bade you pain after pain. And at the time of birth, more pain. And then Allah says, and that person, when he reaches full age and full strength, and especially at 40 years old, he will make the following dua. رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَالِدَيَّ وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ وَأَصْلِحْ لِي فِي ذُرِّيَّتِي إِنِّي تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ. I would strongly advise everybody to go to Surah Ahqaf in a 26th juz and learn this dua so that you can make it every day. Oh Allah, I thank you for your favors which you, oh Allah, have blessed me with, and upon your favors that you put upon my beloved parents, and grant me to do the pious and good deeds that will satisfy you. Oh Allah, grant me to do the pious and the good deeds that will satisfy you. And wa Allah, grant my progeny, my children, my grandchildren, whoever comes, to be righteous. Oh Allah, I have returned to you and I am of those who submit to you. In the next surah, in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says to us, مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي هُعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The similitude and the example of the paradise of Jannah that Allah has promised us. Now that's a key word. Why is the key word? Because if Allah makes a promise, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِئَادِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never break Allah's promise. So the example and similitude of the paradise that Allah has promised us, فِيهَا أَنْهَارٌ مِنْ مَاءٍ غَيْرِ آسٍ. In that Jannah, in the paradise, are rivers of pure water. وَأَنْهَارٌ مِنْ لَبَنٍ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ. And rivers of pure milk, which the taste will never change. And and anharun min khamrin ladhat al sharibin, and rivers of pure wine, not the wine of this world that makes you drunk, pure wine that people will enjoy. And listen to the last one, wa anharun min asalin musaffa, and rivers. Can you imagine the rivers in paradise of pure honey? Allahu Akbar. Why are we fasting? Because Allah wants us to be of the muttaqeen, of those people who have been promised Jannah. Now we go to Surah Al-Hujarat. In this surah, Allah teaches us the best of character. The first lesson Allah gives us, do not put yourself forward in front of Allah and in front of Rasulullah. What does it mean? In any matter of this world, you must first check what does Allah says about it and what does Rasulullah. Don't you jump. That is the adab that you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second lesson that Allah gives us in this surah, لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي. Don't raise your voices above the voice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ولا تجهروا لو بالقول كجهر بعضكم. And do not call him by his name like you call your one another by your names. The lesson that we learn is, people on top of us, our mothers, our fathers, our older brother, older sister, our aunts, our ustaz, our teachers, don't raise your voices in front of them and don't call them by their names. Imagine you call your own father by his name or your mother by her name or your father-in-law by his name. No, you must respect them. Call them beloved father, beloved mother, or any beautiful way that shows respect. Listen to the following sacred guidance. Allah says, whenever a wicked person comes to you with information, with news, first ascertain and verify. Don't take what people are saying to you about others. First verify before you're going to take action, and afterwards you're going to regret. And then Allah says, innamal mu'minuna ikhwa, the believers are but a single brotherhood and sisterhood. So make peace and reconciliation between your contending brothers and sisters. If any two people in your family or outside your family of the believers are fighting with one another, it is our duty to bring peace and reconciliation amongst them. And then Allah says to us, O you believe, do not make a mockery of one another. And do not defame and insult yourselves. Why does Allah say, do not defame and insult yourselves? Because we are one single brotherhood and sisterhood. So if you defame and insult others, you're actually defaming yourself. And then Allah says, and do not call each other by offensive nicknames. And listen to the next lessons. Oh, you believe, avoid suspicion as much as possible. Oh, only have good thoughts about one another. Our beloved Nabi Muhammad says, suspicion is the worst form of lies. And then Allah says, do not spy on each other. And in conclusion, Allah says, don't speak bad about any other believer in the absence. Do not backbite one another. Would you like the idea of eating the dead flesh of your brother? No, you will dislike it. You will abhor it, says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your brother is still alive. Why are you eating his flesh? Jamaat Muslimin, on that note, we want to make sure that from this year onwards, all of us, we're not going to backbite one another. In fact, my beloved colleague, Mufti Ming, said now the other day, if this ummah wants to move forward, all of us, we must decide that we're not going to speak bad about any Muslim, but we're only going to mention and speak good about all of them. Once again, it was an honor and a privilege to have spoken to you. And until we see tomorrow night, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا
بسنتهم جلا نوري لهدي الحق أرشدنا
كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا بسنتهم جلا